Every once in a while, astronomers make a discovery that is so bizarre, it challenges everything we know about the universe and how it can be so different from what we consider to be normal on Earth. There are many interesting exoplanets out there. Some are completely frozen, while others have scorching hot temperatures. But now, scientists have announced the discovery of a planet that is covered in hot ice. So, let's take a closer look at this astounding discovery. First discovered in 2004, GJ-436b is a planet around 22 times more massive than the Earth. It orbits a diminutive red dwarf star 30 light years away from us. New observations of the planet as it passed in front of its parent star allowed scientists to measure its size and mass. GJ-436b is the closest and smallest transiting planet to be measured in this way. The measurements, made using a telescope at the Observatoire François-Xavier Bugnion in St. Luc, Switzerland, revealed GJ-436b has a diameter of about 30,000 miles, which is four times that of Earth. Based on its size and mass, scientists think that the planet is composed mostly of water. If the planet were a gas giant like Jupiter or Saturn and contained mostly hydrogen and helium, it would be much larger. And if it was made up of rock and iron, like Earth and Mars, it would be much smaller. The water world could be enveloped by a thin atmosphere of hydrogen and helium, like Neptune and Uranus, or could be surrounded by water, like Saturn's moon Enceladus. GJ-436b orbits its star from a distance of only about 2.5 million miles, which is around 14 times closer than Mercury's average distance from the Sun. At such close quarters, scientists think its surface temperature is at least 600 degrees Fahrenheit, and any water in its atmosphere would be in the form of steam. Scientists agree that water on the surface of the planet is a different matter. The pressures on GJ-436b are so great that water would adopt forms not found anywhere on Earth except in laboratories. This is because water has more than a dozen solid states, while we are only familiar with one of these states, which is ice. In the same way that carbon can transform into diamonds under extreme pressures, the water turns into other solid states denser than both liquid and ice under very high pressures. Physicists call these alternative forms of water Ice 7 and Ice 10. From the seas of Antarctica to the depths of your freezer, most ice on Earth is relatively tame stuff. But throughout the solar system and beyond, extreme temperatures and pressures can crush the frozen substance into increasingly odd varieties. Years of research have allowed scientists to take a closer look at some of these varieties, one being a highly electrically conductive material known as superionic ice. This ice exists at pressures between 1 and 4 million times that at sea level and temperatures half as hot as the surface of the Sun. While normally unachievable on Earth, such conditions should be present deep inside the watery giants Uranus and Neptune, potentially helping to explain how these distant planets work, including the origins of their unusual magnetic fields. Scientists already know of 17 varieties of crystalline ice, and more than 30 years ago, physicists predicted that crushing pressure should squeeze water into superionic forms. Superionic materials are dual beasts, part solid and part liquid, that on a microscopic level consist of a crystal lattice permeated by free-floating atomic nuclei that can carry an electrical charge. In water, aka H2O, the oxygen atoms would crunch into a solidified crystal, while the hydrogen's protons would zip around like a liquid. Recently, another team of scientists working with potassium confirmed the existence of a state of matter that is solid and liquid at the same time. In 2018, a team of scientists found the first evidence for superionic ice using diamond anvils and laser-induced shockwaves to compress liquid water so much that it turned to solid ice for a few billionths of a second. The team's measurements showed that the water ice briefly became hundreds of times more electrically conductive than it had previously been, a strong hint that it had gone superionic. In their latest test, the researchers used six giant laser beams to generate a sequence of shockwaves that crunched a thin layer of liquid water into solidified ice at millions of times Earth's surface pressure and between 3,000 and 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Precisely timed X-ray flashes probed the configuration, which again only lasted for a few billionths of a second, and revealed that the oxygen atoms had indeed taken on a crystalline form. The oxygen was seen to be tightly packed into face-centered cubes, little boxes with an atom at each corner and one in the middle of each side. This is the first time that water ice has been seen taking on such an arrangement. While there was some overlapping conditions between the team's two experiments, more investigations will be necessary to definitively prove that the ice is superionic. The fact that matter can arrange itself in such a large variety of forms is quite astonishing, and these findings are already changing our models of Uranus and Neptune. Often known as ice giants, these enormous worlds are around 65% water, plus some ammonia and methane, which forms layers, much like the rocky metallic surface, mantle, and core of Earth. These experiments indicate that Uranus and Neptune should have a superionic ice layer that acts like our planet's mantle, which is made of solid rock that still flows on extremely long geological timescales. And that could help explain why they have unusual magnetic fields. The magnetic fields of Earth, Jupiter, and Saturn are all thought to be created by internal dynamos near their cores. These planets' fields are aligned fairly closely with their axes, as if they are coming from bar magnets sticking through the planet's centers. Neptune's magnetic field, by contrast, seems to come from an internal bar magnet that has drifted down to one side, with its ends emerging from spots halfway to the equator. Uranus is even more outlandish, like a bar magnet that has flipped upside down, meaning its magnetic south juts out from the planet's northern hemisphere. Both ice giants' magnetic fields are suspected of being unstable. Scientists have suggested that there could be a liquid layer at the top edge of Uranus and Neptune's superionic ice layer, but that it is also a highly electrically conductive phase of water. The planet's magnetic fields might originate here, far closer to the surface than the magnetic fields of other worlds, potentially explaining their wonky characteristics. And since astronomers have discovered many Neptune and Uranus-sized exoplanets, the findings are also applicable to similar planets in the universe, including GJ-436b. In 2018, NASA's Kepler Space Telescope mission came to a predictable end after it ran out of fuel some 94 million miles from Earth. During its 9-year planet-hunting mission, Kepler discovered nearly 3,000 exoplanet candidates and more than 2,600 confirmed exoplanets in our galaxy, cementing the notion that our solar system isn't all that special. Although it has been decommissioned, Kepler's legacy lives on. Scientists are still sifting through thousands of candidate exoplanets, a task that will keep them busy for many years to come. Kepler has also shaped future missions, such as the Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, or TESS. Launched in April 2018, TESS is NASA's latest planet hunter. Its mission is to survey planets orbiting 200,000 of some of the brightest stars close to Earth. And now, planets identified by TESS can be inspected for a closer look by the recently launched James Webb Space Telescope. Besides TESS, there are also other exciting exoplanet-hunting missions, such as Europe's characterizing exoplanet satellite. Its mission is that of a follow-up. It is tasked with studying stars known to harbor planets, rather than surveying the sky in search of new ones. By performing observations of multiple planetary transits, the mission can provide more precise measurements of a planet's size, which can be combined with existing mass determinations to render accurate densities. Knowing these parameters, it is possible to determine the exoplanet's composition and discriminate between Earth-like planets, where life may blossom, and other types of Earth mass planets that challenge our current notions of habitability. In 2026, the ESA will launch PLATO, which is short for the Planetary Transits and Oscillations of Stars mission. PLATO is designed to find and determine the properties of Earth-like planets that orbit the habitable zone around stars similar to the Sun. For the first time, PLATO will allow scientists to calculate accurately the properties of a large number of stars with planets, including their ages. All of these missions, both past, present, and future, will provide scientists with sufficient data to continue hunting for new exotic planets for decades to come. This data will also be invaluable to further decoding the mysteries of already discovered exoplanets such as GJ-436b. If you like this video, please consider checking out this one, which talks about NASA's TESS mission and how it discovered 70 rogue planets without a star. Do you think NASA will discover more planets with hot ice? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.